The Bible says, in the book of Colossians, chapter 2 and verse 7, you're deeply rooted in him. You're well constructed upon him. You know your way around the faith. Now, do what you've been taught. School's out. Quit studying the subject and start living it. And let your living spill over into thanksgiving. This past year has been unprecedented, but we're not here to feel sorry about time and experiences that have been lost. We're here this evening to remember that faith can fuel us forward. And at Bethany, putting your faith in God is a value taught and modeled. So, like the verse read, you know your way around the faith. Now do what you've been taught. School's out. Quit studying the subject of faith and start living it.
Members of the Bethany board, teachers, special guests, our dear valedictorians, and all the parents and friends who are following the webcast from your homes. I'm sure this Zoom meeting will be less stressful for you, as your children are not at home, like that picture. Good evening, and welcome to the 45th valedictory ceremony of Bethany High. Our theme for this unique graduation year is Seize the Sky, Stay Rooted.
We are here this evening to encourage another batch of graduating students as they formulate their aspirations for the future. We do this every year, but this year is very unique. Evil has engulfed our world in the form of a virus.
But we are here this evening because the human spirit does not give up that easily. Our feet may be constrained by the earth's shores, but we can still dream of the heavens and beyond. The possibilities are always limitless.
That sounds like something C.S. Lewis once said. Aim at heaven and you will get earth thrown in. Aim for earth and you will get neither.
That's so profound. Come to think of it, it's also an excellent backdrop for the entry of our radiant valedictorians of 2021. Let's welcome our valedictorians as a choir sings Keep Me in the Moment by Jeremy Camp. The lyrics are an accurate, timely message, and I quote, O Lord, keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes wide open. Throw away whatever I'm chasing after, because I don't want to miss what you have for me.
Keep me in the moment. Keep me in the moment. this. I don't want to miss.
Sing it, oh Lord, show me what matters. Throw away what I'm chasing after. Cause I don't want to miss what you have for me.
Keep me in the moment.
Welcome, our brave young valedictorians of 2021. We salute you. You've had an academic year unlike any other batch in the history of the world. But here you are, ready to look forward to seize the sky and walk into limitless possibilities that lie ahead in your future.
Aiming for the sky is the right attitude. But for it to produce fruit, it needs to be rooted in God's principles. We now move into the baccalaureate service, where we will spend about 20 minutes in worship and a short devotional from the Bible.
Right, we're going to spend a few minutes, like Neil just mentioned, take a few minutes to tune our hearts to God in worship, the word and prayer. So why don't we quieten our hearts and join together as we sing the song Still. You all know the words. We sing this a lot, but it's still so powerful. Hide me now under your wings. Within your mighty hands, and when the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. And Father, you are King over the flood, and I will be still and know you are God. I will be still and know you are God.
Find rest, my soul, in Christ alone. Know His power in quietness and trust.
And when the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. And Father, you are King over the flood, and I will be still and know you are God. I will be still and know you.
Can you all just sing with me?
When the oceans rise and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are King over the flood, and I will be still and know you. I will be still and know you are God.
Angel Ma'am will now lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, throughout the past highly unprecedented year, the waves of uncertainty were and continue to rise against us. The threat of the virus hovers around us, but we hold on to the promises in your word, which says, if you make the Lord your God your refuge, if you make the Most High your shelter, no evil will conquer you, no plague will come near your home. for he will order his angels to protect you wherever you go. We put our trust in you, O God. We ask that your presence will guide and guard us this evening. We pray in the most powerful name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, ma'am. As Neil just mentioned, the theme for today is an encouragement for all of you graduates to seize the sky and do that as you stay rooted in God. To aim for the limitless possibilities that lie ahead for each one of you, the biggest hindrance is the space between your years. God's design for you is to see you blossom, but the voices inside your head derail those plans. In one word, your identity defines who you become.
One of the most famous basketball players of recent years, the late Kobe Bryant, said, "If you do not believe in yourself, no one else will do it for you." We forget that who we are and get swayed by what our friends think of us most of the time, what your parents think of us, what our identity is, what our teachers think of us affects our identity. What some random influencer on Facebook or Instagram says affects our identity. The external influences will never end. We will always be bombarded by messages that distort the truth. But there is only one permanent solution. Let's join in and sing Beat of Your Love, which actually has the answers.
Are we going to stand? Are we going to have somebody lead with the dance? Come on, Kushi Ritika, come on.
Your love is deep, deeper than my fear. It's wide, wider than my doubt. It's all that I will ever need. Your love is high, higher than my hopes. It's strong, stronger than my past. It's all that I will ever need. Oh, you've got me singing. Oh, oh, let your love transform. Oh, yeah, let your love transform. Sing into the whole world. I come to the sound of your love again. Let your love transform. Oh, yeah, let your love transform. Sing into the whole world. I come to the sound of your love again. Your love is deep, oh, deeper than my fear is wide, oh, wider than my path. It's all, oh, all that I will ever need. Your love is high, higher than my hopes. It's all, oh, singing, oh, oh, let your love transform. Oh, yeah, let your love transform. Sing into the whole world. I come to the sound of your love again.
Special guests, you're welcome to sit down if you want to.
Dancing to the beat of
special
your
guests,
love,
you can sit down if you
love.
Want to.
We're dancing to
or
the
you can
beat
join
of
it.
Your love, your love. We're dancing to the beat, dancing to the beat of your love.
Yes, your love.
We're dancing to the beat of your love, your love. We're dancing to the beat of your love, your love.
Your love over
dancing
us.
Dancing to the beat. Dancing to the beat of your love.
Your love.
Let your love transform. Oh, let your love transform. Sing into the whole world. I come to the sound of your love again. I come to the sound of your love again. I come to the sound of your love again.
Amen, amen. Thank you. Minnie Ma'am will now read a verse from the Bible.
John 15, verse 13 to 15. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you slaves, because a master doesn't confide in his slaves. Now you are my friends, since I have told you everything the Father told me. Amen.
In that verse, Jesus gives us the key to identity. We're not some human beings living random lives on this planet called Earth. We are called friends, not servants, friends of God. Servants are not involved in decision making. Servants just get the job done. And friends, on the other hand, get involved and have a stronger connection with the Master. So if we are friends of God, then the whole storyline changes. If you're not beautiful according to worldly standards, doesn't matter. You're a friend of the living God. If you're short and plump, doesn't matter. You're a friend of the God who created the universe. If you don't get enough marks to get into IIT, it doesn't matter. You're a friend of a miracle-working God, and something else better will open up. Only an identity that is rated based on what God thinks of you is going to help you. Let me say that again. Only an identity that is rated based on what God thinks of you is going to help you. Mona Ma'am will now close in prayer.
Father, you know the voices in our head are negative at times. One day we are strong, the next we are not. We want to have the strength of character that comes from knowing that we are friends of God. Your word says that in your strength we can crush an army. With my God, I can scale any wall. Father God, we pray that you will fill us all with confidence that comes from your Spirit's work within our minds, so that we may gain ground and cross over the obstacles ahead. And let seizing the impossible become a normal phenomenon for us. In the name of Jesus, your Son, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, ma'am. We have one more song, again, a favorite from all of you. And again, it just puts the whole perspective so clearly that God is good all the time. We just need to see that. So can we stand up for that? Students, you know the song. Special guests, you're welcome to join us. If you want to sit down, you can do that too.
I wanna scream and
with a shout of praise. Our hearts celebrate that you are good. You are good. In the sun or rain, my heart celebrates that you are good. And you are good. And I sing because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me.
No, no.
And I sing because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me.
Whoa.
Think about it, that's what your identity should be based on, that God is good. Thank you very much. May we be seated.
Thank you, Music and Drama Department, for helping us direct our thoughts and affections to God as we begin this evening's ceremony.
We now move into the valedictory ceremony, and I invite our principal, Mr. Robert Khin, to address the gathering. You know, I always look out for Robert Sir's quirky humor, and I truly admire his down-to-earth sense of practicality in facing problems and finding solutions.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Nisha, for that intro. I didn't realize that I had humor. I thought I was never a humorous person. The humorous person in our midst is Dr. Akash there, and he's got all the humor. But thank you, Nisha. I think you'll get 5 extra marks from me for that lovely introduction in your English language. You know, ladies and gentlemen, the boys and girls, our graduates, with all the challenges, the chances, and the changes that we have had, we never thought that we could have a function like this with you being present here in person. But we're just thankful this evening that we could do this. We were mulling the idea of having an online program, but then all of us thought that you had missed out on all the activities that the Bethany has had, and Bethany has a lot of activities. You missed out on the Founders Day, you missed out on the annual sports meet, you missed out on the carnival, and we said we must have this for you. And so this evening we are so happy to have each one of you, seeing you after a year. You know, this lockdown happened on March 13th, I think, and from then we have not seen you. Once in a way, we see you online, but sometimes you don't tend to put on your video, so we don't see you. But we are happy to see you this evening. I think your teachers are happy to see you. So can we give a round of applause and welcome to our students, all our students. Just the day before they had come onto the campus, they had 2 rehearsals, and today we are having this graduation program. You know, there are about 40 plus, I think, graduating batches that have passed out the portals of Bethany High School, but no other graduating batch earlier had this experience of such a change so sudden that it took all of us by surprise, right, like I said, from the month of March 2020. But we commend each of our students for adapting to the change so well, so quickly, that today, at the end of this academic year, you are prepared to do your board exam, whether it be online or offline. I think you have the practice of both. So all the best to each of you as you prepare for your board exam. You know, this evening, like I said, we had to do a lot of changes to this program. We would have loved to have many other people. Some significant sections of our audience are not with us this evening. And those are our parents of the class 10 and 12. But this evening, we know that they are watching online. We are live streaming this whole program. And we want to thank the parents for being there with them. I know all of them are tuning in. And so I asked the students to just put your hands for all your parents. The second significant section of our audience, which we normally is there with us, is here, is all your teachers who have taught you, I think most of you, from the pre-primary department to the middle school to class 7. They too could not be here because of the situation we are in. But I'm sure they too are tuning in, and they, as they look at you, they are proud of you that you have made this milestone in your education. So put your hand together for all your pre-primary, primary, and your middle school teachers. Another large section of our audience who are not able to attend and who would always look forward to attend with so much of gusto is your juniors, class 9 and class 11. And they would have loved to have been with you tonight and send you off with that vibrant cultural program that they always do for every batch. But don't worry, they too wish you all the best. They wish you well. So put your hands together for your juniors also. But this evening, we are happy that you have your teachers of class 10, class 12, and your teachers from the NIOS department. They are here. They are surrounding you with their blessing and their love. Can I ask the teachers to just stand up? And students, will you just give them a grateful and a loving round of applause? Teachers, please stand up. Turn around to your teachers. Thank you, teachers. We also want to warmly welcome members of our board this evening who inspire and encourage us at every step that we do here in Bethany. They are such a great support. I want to recognize Dr. Anthony Robert Charles, our president of the Bethany Education Board, Mrs. E.H. Ryall, Ms. Ann Ryall, Ms. Jillian Leslie, Ms. Shanthi. I won't pronounce your surname in case I... Mr. Natarajan is not here, but Mr. Arun Samuel is here, and Dr. Akash is here, all our board members. Our special guests, a warm welcome to all our special guests, Mr. and Mrs. Vijay Reddy and their two daughters. Where are you, Mr. Vijay? Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thanks. Yeah. And his family. Mr. Hafiz and his wife. We thought they were parents and we nearly asked them to gently leave, but you know, then I realized that you know they've been invited. They're in the later part of the program. They have sponsored a trophy for the outgoing students. Mr. Jugno Broy is not here. Dr. Vinod Joseph is not here. We are happy to also have another guest with us, Mr. Sampath Kumar, who is the CEO of Next Education. Thank you, Mr. Sampath Kumar. I just saw him this morning and invited him, and he's here. He's based in Chennai. Of course, a special, special welcome to our guest speaker, Dr. Timmappa Hegde, Director and Senior Consultant, Neurosurgeon, Narayana Institute of Neuroscience, Mazumdar Shaw Medical Center. He will be introduced formally a little later in the program. But let me tell you, through all this pandemic and lockdowns and the changes that we have gone through, the one most important person who took care of us, and we need to welcome him into our presence this evening, into our midst, is the God above. He is the author and finisher of our faith, the one who guides and leads us. So let's put our hands together for the one who has been faithful. And because of his faithfulness, we have been able to do what we have done, been able to complete this academic session fully and with success. So a warm welcome to each and every one of you. Over to our next presenter, Srihan.
Thank you, Robert, sir, for focusing our thoughts towards this unforgettable evening.
Our founder, Mrs. Mignon David, had implicit faith in God and led her life based on two words: trust and obey. Unconditional trust in God and unquestioning obedience to God. We now request you to stand for our school song, Onward, Ever Onward, in which both these values are enshrined.
Isn't it so true that hope is the reason we are here today? At Bethany, we are constantly encouraged to look past the mundane and to always look at the extraordinary. We are taught to always look at the limitless possibilities.
The sky is not the limit.
Infinite possibilities.
The world is your oyster.
Hold that line of thought, please. We'll talk about seafood a little later. We actually have a parent of one of our valedictorians who is going to share a few words with us tonight.
Thank you, Dr. Akash. Under your direction, it's been a blessing for our kids to be there. Thank you so very much, dear Principal Sir Robert Khin. Thank you to all the teachers, very specially to dear baby auntie. When both our children, Joshua and Jeffrey, they joined Bethany from another large school. We brought them to Bethany because we just loved the ambience there of so much of positive environment where children grow simply because it's based on merits, it's based on a lot of morals and a lot of emphasis on spiritual. So we just prayerfully applied and we're so glad that our children got seats there in 7th standard and 5th standard. And then they were in the hostel, which is actually called home. It was really their second home. And then, of course, the teachers there have been so very sincere and committed to the cause of children. Jeffrey doing his NIOS in Bethany has probably been one of the greatest gifts in education for him. We're so glad for such a fantastic syllabus and the way Bethany opened up. Thank you, Bethany. Bethany is so much in the forefront of providing children the best of what's there in the country. And Joshua now doing his 12th, Jeffrey doing his 10th. In so many ways, it's been such a memorable experience. The loving, welcoming attitude of the school, such a cooperation of helping the children come up and always been available. So thank you so very much. This is to say a sincere thank you from all of us as parents to this wonderful school. Thank you. The Lord bless and prosper all your efforts, and may God's goodness forever continue to shine through this beautiful institution that is so well appreciated in the city of Bangalore, building the future generations of our nation. God bless.
Thank you so much, sir, for those kind words of appreciation. It's now time to recognize and appreciate those valedictorians who have already tasted from the sweet waters of achievement, the outstanding students from the batch of 2021. I now call upon Mrs. Palomi Ray from Bethany High Sarjapur to start off with the award ceremony.
Good evening, everyone. It's my pleasure to be here to recognize the prize winners of Standard 10 who have excelled in academic and leadership skills. Today, we acknowledge and encourage the second outgoing batch of Bethany High Sarjapur. I would request Mr. C.V. Ramesh, the past president of the Bethany Alumni Association and one of the parents of Bethany institutions, to honor them with their prizes. Let's begin with the C.V. Ramesh Rolling Trophy for Academic Excellence, and it is awarded to Anya Agarwal. Next, we have the Certificate of Excellence. Certificate of Excellence, General Proficiency Academics. Second place is won by Daniel Devasia Joyce. Certificate of Excellence, General Proficiency in Academics, third place is awarded to Cecil Lakaraju. I call upon Daniel Devasia Joyce once again for winning the Certificate of Excellence for Most Promising Leader. I would call Anya Agarwal once again for winning the Certificate of Excellence for Best Outgoing Student. Students were recognized for their excellence during their farewell assembly on December 14th, 2020. I would like to thank Mr. C.V. Ramesh for presenting the awards to our students. Thank you everyone for encouraging them. Have a glorious evening ahead.
To the class of 2020-21, our chief guest, the Bethany Education Board, distinguished guests and teachers, and to all those proud and nervous parents who are peering into their screens trying to catch a glimpse of their beloved child, we greet you a very good evening. From the NIOS department, we would like to honor and celebrate our young achievers. We will start with the general proficiency winners. And for this, may I call upon Mrs. Devika Rani, our former head of NIOS, and a teacher who has served in Bethany for many, many years. From class 10C, we had Shimra Simat in the first place. Jeffrey Thomas Johnson in the second place. Junaid Joel Meer in the third place. From class 10D, we had Catherine Jessica in the first place. Shreya Ashok in the second place. I'm sorry, Shreya was unable to attend this function today. And Ronak Vatsalan coming in at third place. Here at NIOS, we believe in breaking barriers not only in academics, but also in the field of sports. The prize for excellence in sports goes to Kush Thapa. I'm sorry, even Kush was unable to join us today, but let that not stop you from applauding everyone. Right. Moving on, we have two students who have understood that leaders lead from the front and that the buck stops with them. They have been exemplary in their conduct and have discharged their duties faithfully. They are Junaid Joel Mir and Apurva N. We now come to the most coveted title in all of student life, the best outgoing student. These children have shown what it is to dig their heels in and to keep at a task with uncompromising values, because they know patience gives birth to character. The best outgoing student among the boys goes to Manish R. And from among the girls, it goes to Nandita Rajesh. I'm sorry again, Nandita was not able to join us. Thank you. Congratulations once again to all you students. Thank you, ma'am. While many of you may feel why this pandemic had to happen in your final year at school, may we encourage you to flip the script. Instead of asking, why me? God is saying, why not? For maybe you were chosen and handpicked for such a time as this. And God, in His infinite wisdom, knew you had the tools to harness the power of adversity. So God bless and Godspeed.
We shall now continue to celebrate the incredible success of students of Standard 10, 2021. All the students of Standard 10 were appreciated and recognized for their strengths and achievements at the farewell assembly held online on 15 December 2020. Many were recognized for 100% attendance, skill in fine arts, music, sports, leadership, and technology, while many others were appreciated for their cheerful attitude, for being sparklers in self-motivation, good Samaritans, generous givers, responsible students, eager beavers, and active environmentalists. Now is the time to bestow the General Proficiency Awards for academics on students who excelled in studies and achieved the first three ranks in their respective class. It is our privilege to have with us this special evening Miss Gillian Leslie, a member of the Bethany Board. I kindly invite her on stage to do the honors. From Standard 10A, in the first position is Maitri Singh. In the second position is Deepthanshu Nyanesh. And in the third position is Hiten Jain. From Standard 10B, we have in first place Adrija Chattopadhyay. In the second place is Umaima Firdos. In third place, Anvesha Patnaik. In Standard 10C, the first position is shared by Kirtana R. Menon. And Mayuk K. In the second position is Vandita G. From Standard 10D, in the first place is Kushi Shailesh Shetty. the second place is Ritika Ravindra Kurkimat. In third place is Roshan Agarwal. From Standard 10E, in the first position is Prashant G. In the second position is Carol Upasana Stephen. In the third position is Ananya Anil. The Jugnu Oberoi Award, a cash prize of Rs. 5,000, is given to the student who has topped in academics, scoring the highest marks across all sections of Standard 10. This distinct award for 2021 goes to Adrija Chattopadhyay. Bethany's four stars have won accolades at the state and national level. Our school is awarding a cash prize of Rs. 2,500 for the glorious triumph in their respective sport. Angela Jomi. Angela Jomi is an ace table tennis player, the winner of gold medal in the under-18 category at the national level in the CISC Games held in 2019. Leticia Gilbert is our reigning fencing champ. She has a podium finish at the TFF Thailand Open in 2019 and won a bronze in the under-16 category. She also won a bronze at the 20th Sub-Junior National Fencing Championship, another gold at the State Fencing Championship under-17 category in 2019. Congratulations for winning gold, silver and bronze in many other events. Arnav K.A. Shrikant, our very own karate champ, is indeed superb. He won a bronze at the state level championship in 2018, three times winner at the national level. He won the first prize at Kerala in 2019. He has successfully won the third prize in 2019 and 20 at the Republic Day events. Anshuman Singh has chosen a unique sport, horse riding. So being an equestrian champ, he has won many events conducted by the ASC Riding and Polo Academy. He won the first prize in the open dressage held in 2019. Many silver and bronze medals were won in several other events. Congratulations, sports stars. Bethany is proud of your achievements. Thank you, Ms. Jillian Leslie, for your gracious presence in giving away the awards. Integrity, courage, passion, humility, and gratitude makes excellent leaders. I invite Mrs. Tasneem Hafiz to give away the next set of awards. Promising leaders of 2020-21 are Ritika Ravindra Kurkimat, and Raymond Thomas Roshi. The Hafiz Rolling Shield for the best outgoing girl has been donated by Mr. Aziz Hafiz, father of Saida Aliza Hafiz of Standard 9. Kushi Shailesh Shetty is the best outgoing girl of 2020-21. Let's applaud for her. The best outgoing boy is awarded the Vinod Joseph Rolling Trophy. Dr. Vinod Joseph, a reputed radiologist, is an alumnus of Bethany. The best outgoing boy of 2020-21 Any guesses? Mayuk K. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for giving away the words. I quote the words of Maya Angelou. The horizon leans forward, offering you space to place new steps of change. So, wishing all of you success for accomplishing great things in life. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are pleased to tell you that all our students were recognized for their exceptional and diverse talents during our online farewell assembly, the first of its kind, which was conducted on the 14th of December 2020. We will now move on to the other awards from Junior College. And to give away these awards, I invite Mr. Arun Samuel, member of the Bethany Education Board, please come on stage. Please welcome him with a round of applause. The Jugnu Oberoi Award was instituted by Mr. Jugnu Oberoi, former student of Mrs. E.H. Ryall and president of Christ College Alumni Association. He's also a member of the Birla Board and a good friend of the Bethany family. We thank you, sir, for instituting this award. A cash prize of rupees 5,000 each will be given to our ISC toppers. Our ISC toppers are Titiksha Ramesh from 12th Commerce. Martel Ribeiro from 12th Humanities. Martel was unable to join us, but I'm sure she's streaming in this event live from the confines of her home. And from Science, we have Avishi Rajgaria. Kindly stay on, sir, to give away the other awards as well. Our school has instituted an award to recognize those who represented Bethany institutions at the sports meet conducted by the CISCE during this academic year. The recipient of the special award for excellence in badminton is Parth Dinesh Basankar. Parth is an avid badminton player and he has been playing the sport ever since he was in middle school. Congratulations, Parth. We now move on to the general proficiency prizes. From 12th Commerce, the first place goes to Titiksha Ramesh. The second place goes to Erin Ann Lobo. Request all of you to keep the applause equal to all our prize winners today. And the third place goes to Medha Praneeth. From 12th Humanities, we have Martel Ribeiro in the first place. Please applaud for her. She's at home right now. Annie George in the second place. Sakshi Aravind Karandikar in the third place. The general proficiency prizes from 12th Science. In the first place, we have Avishi Rajgaria. In the second place, we have Shreya Gunan Ramkumar. In the third place, we have Tejal Daivagna. The next award is for those leaders who have led by example. The award for good leadership goes to Pranay Prasanna Bailahalli. And Sahana Shiva. This this academic year, Bethany Junior College hosted its first ever online intercollegiate fest called Truvai. Truvai means to find a treasure. This was the brainchild of our student leaders, and two of them were responsible for its inception and seamless execution, because of which our fest became a roaring success. For the very first time, the Truvai Trailblazer Award goes to Leah Valentina D'Souza. And Sahana S. The award for the best outgoing student in sports and games goes to Carlin Simon Joseph. Carlin is the Usain Bolt of Bethany Junior College, an ace sprinter. He also represented the track events in the sports meet organized by the council. Every year, we have students who are beset by many challenges, and they have overcome all of those challenges with a smile on their faces and in the mighty hope that this too shall pass. The award for positive attitude goes to Dhruv Verma from 12th Commerce. And Shivaranjani Shankaraya from 12th Science. Now, for the evening's most coveted award, the Mignon Memorial Rolling Trophy is given to the best outgoing student. And for the batch of 2020-2021, the award for best outgoing student goes to Leah Valentina D'Souza. Thank you, Mr. Arun Samuel. Congratulations to all the prize winners and the entire batch of 2020-2021. God bless you all.
What an inspiration. These outstanding students have given us a glimpse of what any of us can achieve if we aim for the sky.
Speaking of inspiration, dear valedictorians, ladies and gentlemen, we have within our midst a perfect example of diligence and dedication. We're talking about Miss Shanthi Gnanàolivu, the principal of the Bethany Special School, who recently won an award for serving the differently abled for over 50 years.
I call upon Mrs. Shanthi Ravindran, head of department of Bethany Junior School 1, to introduce and recognize Miss Shanthi Gnanàolivu.
Good evening. The 26th of February 2021 was a very special day for the Bethany family. It was on this day that our Shanthi ma'am, the principal of the Bethany Special School, was recognized and honored for the 40 years that she has dedicated to children with special needs. Yes, 40 years. Live so that when your children think of love, fairness, integrity, and tenderness, they think of you. This anonymous quote epitomizes Shanthi ma'am so appropriately. I'm sure that the many students who have passed through her hands will echo this. Our director fondly calls her Shanthi, I love you. And the contentment of the students of the Bethany Special School bear witness to this. Shanthi ma'am's humility masks her many achievements. She holds an MA, a B.Ed, and a degree in special education. She has studied in prestigious institutions like the Women's Christian College, Chennai, and Mysore University, and institutes in the Netherlands and Denmark. She has taught in schools right across India, from Mussoorie in the foothills of the Himalayas to Virudhunagar in the south of India. It was in Virudhunagar that she had a life-changing experience. This incident motivated her to cut short her promising career as a head of school and start from the bottom of the ladder as a special educator. Because, as Lisa Thornbury says, the past haunts and the future taunts. This is particularly true if you love a child with special needs.
Shanthi started all over again from scratch. In 1981, she acquired a degree in special education from KPMRC Bangalore and began working for the Mathoma Church Special School. In 1987, she won a scholarship sponsored by the Bishop Becker's Foundation to study in special education in the Netherlands. The very next year, she won yet another scholarship to study in Denmark. This was sponsored by the Government of India and the Danish government. In 2002, Shanthi was invited by the principal Alain Juniors to start the Hope Center, a special school in Alain, UAE. In 2003, she established Samiksha in Bengaluru, an organization to teach and mentor school dropouts. Later, Samiksha became a center for the NIOS board. In 2004, Shanthi Ma'am joined Bethany Institutions as the vice principal. She says she was so happy to see that the school was housed in a beautiful brand new building set in a garden blooming with flowers. More importantly, it was fully equipped with units for occupational therapy and a bakery. Shanthi Ma'am has used all these resources completely to the great benefit of her students. Every member of the Bethany family is so proud when the students of our special school shine at inter-school events in the city and at the national level and always, always bring back prizes. The students do mat weaving, paint pottery, make cards as part of their occupational therapy. Students, in fact, the candles at today's valedictory are all made by the special school. But the most important aspect of the special school is that it is a sanctuary for its students, and every single one of them is so happy, wreathed in smiles, and confident and eager to meet people. A highlight in Shanthi Ma'am's life was when she accompanied the Indian basketball girls team to the Special Olympics held in the USA in 1991. Much to everyone's joy, the team brought back the gold medal. Later, when the press interviewed Bindu, the star player of the team, in beautiful innocence, she stated, "My teacher prayed and we won." Shanthi Ma'am will never forget this answer to her prayer, for it sums up her close walk with Christ. She gives God all the glory for her achievements. It is her special request that I read this verse from a poem on her behalf. "Something beautiful, something good. All my confusion he understood. All I had to offer him was brokenness and strife, and he made something beautiful of my life." May I call upon Shanthi Gnanàolivu, the principal of the Bethany Special School, to come up on stage. And may I request Mrs. Bharati Ponnappa, the HOD of the pre-primary department of Bethany High, to present the award plaque and an award. Bharati Ma'am, Shanthi Ma'am, from the Bethany family, we wish you God's blessings and many more years of achievement.
We certainly are not lacking for inspiration tonight. And guess what? There's more. This evening, we have with us Mr. Vijay Reddy, CEO of SJR Prime Corp, an old student at our school from the 90s, who has expressed his desire to award 7 of our teachers for their unique impact on his life.
I call upon our director, Dr. Akash Ryall, to explain to us what Mr. Vijay Reddy is so generously planning. Akash, sir, on behalf of all the graduates, our other students and teachers, we deeply appreciate your initiative, along with the Bethany board, to have this valedictory ceremony, not online, but in person. It makes such a meaningful difference to us.
Before I introduce Mr. Vijay Reddy, a very special person here this evening, I just have 2 words of advice to our children. And even before I do that, I want to say hello to all the parents. Unfortunately, I think for the first time, we've not had y'all over here gracing this eventful evening. So we congratulate you, the Bethany board, and all of us here on this achievement. We really miss you, parents. Your presence just fills this place up. And unfortunately, I've had to say no to quite a few parents who requested to be here. And I'm so sorry, because if we had a few of you, then we had no excuse to say no to the others, or yes to the others. So I'm really sorry about that. I also want to recognize the presence of our teachers online and the teachers over here. This evening, without you all, y'all are the backbone of the school, and any amount of infrastructure and all the other things just pale in comparison to the way y'all work so hard. So thank you, teachers. You want to give them another round of applause, kids? Thank you. Okay, I want to leave you with this. Always trust and obey. That's your school motto. That's the first thing that I want to tell you, because you've heard, I think, already a great deal of things that you've got to do and what you've not to do. The second thing I want to tell you to do is to pay attention when our chief guest speaks, because we're so lucky to have Dr. Timmappa Hegde with us this evening, and I'm sure he'll just leave you with pearls of wisdom. So listen carefully when he comes up. All right. This evening, I have the pleasure of recognizing someone very special, someone who sat probably there or there when he studied here in Bethany many years ago. In 1992, he passed out of Bethany, a proud Bethanite. And a few months ago, I received a phone call from Mr. Vijay Reddy. And when I picked up the phone, I thought Vijay will say, "Akash, I need a seat for my manager," or something like that way in Bethany. But it was not to be. He said, "Akash, I want to give back to my teachers. I am what I am today because of them." And as the days went by, we spoke. And this evening, we're going to recognize just a few teachers of his when he was in the 10th grade. He's got something very handsome to give them. I'm not going to mention what it is, except that they're going to walk away tonight really happy that one of their students have done this for them. He says they've made a difference in his life, and tonight he's going to make a difference in their lives. A little earlier, Robert Sir said that I'm the one with the humor, and I don't know whether I should be telling you all this little story, but I'm going to just do it anyways. Okay, Ramesh, since you're looking at me. Back in the day, just like what Vijay is doing today, when we were in school, on Teacher's Day, we were allowed to give gifts to our teachers. And I'm reminded of an old story where there was this teacher who was receiving gifts on Teacher's Day. And she was a very smart teacher. She knew all the kids, she knew their parents very well. So as the kids came up and gave her something, she would know that, for example, Ashok's father had a chocolate shop. So when he brought his gift, she would shake it and say, chocolates. And the boys and the girls would say, "Wow, ma'am, how did you guess? Yes, it's chocolates." And the next one would come with flowers, it would be all wrapped up. She wouldn't make out, but she knew that the girl's mother was a florist, so she said, "Flowers," and they would all yelp and say, "Yes." And then there was this one kid, and as he started walking towards her with his gift, she said, his father owns a liquor store." So anyway, he came up and he gave his gift to her, and she shook it, and there was a little bit of liquid. So she said, "Is this a bottle of wine?" He said, "No, ma'am." So she shook it again and again. She felt something, and she said, "Is it champagne?" He said, "No, ma'am." So she said, "I give up." He said, "Ma'am, it's a puppy." Tonight, the teachers are in for a real treat, and we're so lucky that we have 6 out of the 7 teachers that Vijay is going to recognize. But before we call Vijay up and before we call the staff up, we just want to quickly recognize the presence of his wife, Sweta, and we have something small for her, and his 2 daughters, Nina and Dia. Would you please put your hands together for them? Vijay studied here many years ago, and so did his elder brother. And they have sponsored many of our musicals. I don't know whether you've heard of Bren, that is Bhupesh Reddy's organization, and Bhupesh is Vijay's elder brother. And he sponsored the last musical, if I'm not mistaken, In the Heights. And Vijay has helped us in the past with some of our other musicals. Now, he is such a humble guy. Forget about his good looks and everything else that he has, but he did not want us to say anything, and I mean it. And we did Google searches and all sorts. But let me just tell you, batch of 1992, he's the managing director of SJR Prime Corp Realty. They were adjudged top developers in South India for many years, and in fact, a few years ago was awarded Developer of the Year, South India. Besides his humility, he's magnanimous and generous. And I'm going to call upon Vijay now. He's just going to say a few words, and then we'll recognize those 6 staff members, 2 of them who are here with us even now, and 4 others. Vijay.
A very good evening to all of you here. I wish if words were enough to express my gratitude. It's a very difficult thing. So I just want to thank Bethany, its administrators, and the teachers for who I am today, like, and for their unconditional sacrifice which they've done teaching over the years. I still see them teaching, though it's been I think nearly close to 3 decades, 30 years, I think 92, so 29 years to 30 years. So I really appreciate the fact and their sacrifice for creating so many students. I think I'm sure they've created many successful students to whatever, I think I really thank them from bottom of my heart. I think I have no words to say, but I would like to thank them once more, and it's a small gesture from my side for them, what I could do, I request all you students to, value their sacrifice, and then, be good humans, and make it a better and beautiful ecosystem. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to call upon Mrs. Shobha Joseph first. Shobha. Thank you. Ma'am, there's one more thing. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I'll call upon Mrs. Emmy Prabhakar. besides that check that they will receive, there's a bag of goodies for them. In fact, it's a carton of, it's such a big, huge gift carton that we'll send it across to them tomorrow. Thank you. Big round of applause for Mrs. Prabhaka. Next, can I call upon Mrs. Nancy Fernandez? Round of applause for Nancy ma'am. Mrs. Devi Karani. This big round of applause for Mrs. Devi Karani. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. The other day when she came to school, she gave me a big hug. Today, she didn't even look at me. Now for our very own Mrs. Bala ma'am. Thank you, Bala ma'am. There's something for Miss Usha Devi, but she's in the US right now. So, Vijay, you'll have to make a trip over there and give her her gift. Okay. One last person, and he's going to come running up, I'm sure. Peter Soundarajan. Come on, Peter. Yes. He's still rocking, Vijay. Peter's looking nice and warm now. Yes, give them all a big round of applause. Thank you. I was told earlier not to mention the amount that they're receiving. Would you like to know how much they're getting? Do you think it'd be okay, Vijay, if I tell them? You think it's okay, no, Vijay? Yeah. Each one of them are going to get 2 lakhs of rupees and a gift bag worth 50,000. So 2.5 lakhs. Please put your hands together for Mr. Vijay Reddy. When y'all can be seated, when we mentioned this to the board, the Bethany Education Board felt so overwhelmed that a student could come forward and do something like this individually to his teachers that they thought we should give Vijay something, and we're going to give him something small. So I'm going to call upon our principal, Mr. Robert Khin, to come and do the honors. Would you please stand up and give Vijay a big round of applause for being so magnanimous and generous. That's a little that symbolizes what he does. And this is what's written on that memento. Thank you for inspiring our children by example to stay rooted even as they fly high. As you continue to expand your horizons, Vijay, and scale new summits, may the Bethany values of trust and obey always point you in the right direction. Thank you very much. Children, stay rooted, seize the sky. And if you can't seize the sky, you can just come and give me a tight hug. It'll be like seizing the sky, in a way. Please be seated. Bala ma'am, would like to say just a few words in appreciation of what's happened this evening.
On behalf of all of us recognized today, I would like to share some fond memories of Vijay. Vijay Reddy, we fondly call him as Vijay, when he was a student of Bethany. We are happy to have his family also with us. Now his two daughters got alerted to listen about their father. Vijay was ever smiling. You can see his beautiful smile even now. We can see a smile on his face even now, I told already. As a student, he was very polite and down to earth. He had great rapport with his teachers as well as with his fellow students. He was a boy of few words, but always surrounded by a group of friends and enjoyed thoroughly his school life. As far as I remember, he was fond of cars, used to have a white gypsy, right? Yeah. Okay, he was unassuming, I can say. When his name was proposed for the post of a office bearer of Minon House, I was the counselor of Minon House, but he did not get the role because he was too gentle and too soft-spoken. We thought he couldn't manage. Now we are happy to see the same Vijay rising to greater heights and raising premier high-rise buildings in Bangalore and just now I heard in other cities also. We are glad that he always remained connected with Bethany, to his roots at Bethany, and also most importantly to the values inculcated in Bethany. He is respectful, loving, and made us to be a part of joyous moments in his life. Vijay, we greatly appreciate and cherish this gesture of your love and gratitude to us, who taught you long ago, as you said, around 30 years ago. Our sincere thanks to your parents for your upbringing and to Bethany for inculcating such values in its students. Vijay and family, may God bless you with good health, happiness, peace and prosperity. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Bala ma'am. Okay, wow, now that was something that was just totally out of this world and I'm truly overwhelmed. So my fellow graduates, let's all take a hint that we must always give back to our teachers because they are the ones who make us who we are. We will now have another parent share from their heart.
Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and dear children. It is indeed a great honor to be speaking on the graduation day of my son Ruben and his friends. May the unique circumstances with regard to the COVID pandemic give you resilience and inspire you to respect and value more of what you have and move ahead. Dear members of the board, academic, administrative, and support staff of Bethany High, you didn't just educate our children, you taught them the importance of education. You were kind and considerate, but played the stickler when needed. You played a key role in molding our children into good citizens of the country. We are deeply indebted to you. Dear children, wish you all the very best for your upcoming board exams. God bless you all.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, something really entertaining and unique is about to happen. The valedictorians are going to perform for us. And not just the choir on stage, the entire batch has been practicing the dance steps for this song. So, follow the dance leaders and let's all groove to this incredibly infectious reggae tune, Break Open the Sky by Toby Mac. Special guest, if you're interested to see our dear valedictorians perform, please take a look around you. They're singing a song of anticipation as we wait for a crack in the sky. Side by side, we recognize that hope has brought us together tonight.
Like they mentioned, if you want to see the dance, you need to maybe turn your chairs around and see what's happening, because they've really practiced, but it will be really fun.
Song of anticipation as we wait for a crack in the sky.
brought us together.
That was exhilarating, wasn't it? We created unforgettable memories here tonight. And yet, the well of inspiration has still not run dry. We are now going to spend some time with our guest speaker, Dr. Timappa Hegde. And to introduce Dr. Hegde and welcome him, we invite Mrs. Malika Dorothy, who is head of department of the high school Kormanga.
Good evening, everybody. It is an honor to introduce Dr. Timmappa Hegde, our guest speaker for today's valedictory. We received a brief profile about him, but it doesn't do justice to a doctor who, when Googled, it says, the best neurosurgeon in Bangalore. Dr. Hegde is presently the director of Narayana Institute of Neurosciences Bangalore, which he founded in 2004. It is now recognized as one of the finest centers for neurology and neurosurgery. On reading what his patients have to say about him, the words amazing, wonderful, a genius, and full of humility stand out. I'm sure he rightfully deserves these titles. The Lions Club recognized him as an outstanding citizen. Dr. Hegde has specialized training from CMC Velo, the US, Japan, and Netherlands. Graduating class, I'm sure many of you will choose the noble profession of medicine, and you have the best example in Dr. Hegde, who has been impacting lives. I urge you to listen to Dr. Hegde's TEDx talk on the right way to use the right brain. Dr. Hegde speaks about a wide variety of topics in the podcast, The Mindful Neurosurgeon. He speaks on the connection between science and spirituality, communication and parenting, and about his inspirations in life. This podcast was recorded in October 2019, and as you listen to it, you realize how relevant it is to these unusual times we are living in. Dr. Hegde has a keen interest in personality development. We are so fortunate, sir, to have you in our midst, and I'm sure your talk will leave a lasting impression both in the adults and children alike.
Let me begin with a prayer which is very particularly meaningful for me. It's from Tagore, which goes like this. Life of my life, I shall ever try to keep my body pure, knowing it is thy living touch upon all my limbs. I will drive all untruths from my mind, knowing that thou art the truth that has kindled the light of reason in my mind. I will drive all evil from my heart, knowing that thou hast thy seat in my inmost shrine of my heart. And it shall be my endeavor to reveal thee through my actions, knowing it is thy power that gives me strength to act, life of my life. This beautiful evening, which started so spectacularly with so much music, with so much dance, right from the moment we walked in with dance steps, and every moment was so meaningful, the backdrop, that beautiful moon up in the sky, so significant of being rooted to the earth and to seize the sky. Akash, you've chosen a very relevant theme, and it's so meaningful. Congratulations to all the graduating students. It's your day. To all your parents who are online, I might be focusing a little more, not because there are girls here, but because the camera is there, because I'm speaking to the parents also. And now with all the online presentation, we are trained to focus on the camera. To all the teachers who have made them who they are, to the management, to the principal, Mr. Robert, Chairman Akash Ryall, to the board led by Dr. Anthony Robert Charles, to special donors, Vijay Reddy and your family, and all the other donors and invitees who are here. I made this prayer because I've largely forgotten what I have to speak. You know, when you get involved in whatever you have to say, You get so lost, and that is why I said, let him speak through me. You know, Akash and the management have given me some 20 minutes, so I will just see how he can connect me to you, and that is my theme. I have no idea what I'm going to speak. Let it come naturally. I remember my graduation day. When I graduated from school, at that time we had an outstanding cardiac surgeon, Dr. Jerry Mascarenhas, many of you wouldn't know. He was also a parent of one of us, and he was very impressive. He was a big man, and his opening words, you know, on a graduating day, normally you don't listen to speeches, you may not register speeches, but those speeches you do remember, and at least I remember the opening sentence. He says, "You are no longer schoolboys now," that he said because we were all boys at that time, "but young men with a purpose." I will use his whole words and say, "You are no longer schoolboys or schoolgirls now, but young men and women with a purpose." Many years later, I finished school. I finished my medical graduation, and I applied for some position in St. John's, and he was there as the person who was interviewing, and with his booming voice, he asked me, "What's your aim?" I heard it as, "What's your name?" And I meekly told my name. He boomed again, "What's your aim?" In spite of his graduation day speech, I had no aim. I just finished my graduation. I saw an advertisement. I put my resume. I don't know what I mumbled, because that's what I was. And fortunately, there was nobody behind me, and there was nobody else. I got that post. St. John's was my, what shall I say, launching pad. It was about 7 months in St. John's, but it was an institution where there was medicine, there was religion, there was so much in that place. And that was a launching pad that took me to NIMHANS, where I graduated from NIMHANS. NIMHANS is an outstanding place. Like IIT for engineering, you get one of the best brains immediately after MBBS. They come to train to become neurologists and neurosurgeons. And then I spent a long time of my life there. Then I went to Narayan Hrudayalaya and so on. Talking about purpose. As I said, when I graduated, I had no idea of purpose. When I finished my medical school and was taking a job, I had no idea of purpose. But still, let me speak about purpose, because purpose is not something anybody else can give it to you. You know, I was amazed by what amount of talent all of you have, and the talent that you have displayed, and the skills far out from horse riding to, you know, creating so many things that you have done. Because all my school life, believe me, I've never come up to the stage to receive any prize. I've never been good in academics or in sports or in leadership or in nothing. That means I would identify with those who have nothing, but still, it is possible to be rooted into the ground, to be just a nobody, but also to have a space in the sky. The sky is so vast. The sky is available for just everybody to claim it as your piece. And I would like to share with you what one ancient Indian master had said, and this will help you to come to purpose. You know, I'm just giving you an outline, and you can identify by that what is my purpose. This ancient Indian master has said, all of us have three debts, and in Sanskrit it is called rinas. At this moment, you are seated here, and it is an important day for you when you are graduated from a great school like this. I know, when you feel grateful, whom do you feel grateful to most? It is your parents, because they are the ones who sponsored you, who brought you to this world, who gave you so much. So the first debt is called Pitra Rina, or debt to our parents. And we all know how much our parents have done to you. In a way, we don't know. I'll tell you have to become a parent one day to know what the amount of commitment a parent has to a child. And our life is such that, you know, we always have received from our parents, and then we get into our careers, we get into our families, we have very little time for our parents, and there is always a feeling that I have not been able to give to my parents what they have given to me. So this ancient Indian master has given us a way how to pay this Pitra Rina, or debt to your parents. And this is what he says. You know, what is the greatest joy for parents? I know the parents are watching. The greatest joy for your parents is if somebody can come and say how lucky your parents are that they have a daughter or a son like you. If you are able to get this message across to your parents, you have fulfilled the first debt, that is called Pitrarina. The second is called Lokarina. Lokarina is what is demonstrated by Vijay Reddy. You know, as you grow, life blesses you, especially when you have come from a good background where you are taught to do things the way it should be done, to give in your very best whatever. And life will reward you as you go on. And when life rewards you, what you need to see is how I can give more than what I have received. Just like as Vijay has demonstrated in his own way, all of us should be motivated to see how I can give back more to the community than what I have given. And if this is my vision, I fulfill debt number two. The third and the most difficult debt is symbolized by the theme of today's meeting. That is, if I get the words right, stay rooted to the ground and seize the skies. Be rooted and yet to seize the skies. How do we work on that? As we leave school and as we go further into academics, you will see life is so competitive. And for that, in all ways, you need a fit body and a fit mind. I saw one of your girls who had come up to receive a prize, and her name was Titiksha. Krishna gives a lot of importance to what is called Titiksha. And this is my morning prayer. This is a verse in the Bhagavad Gita which goes like this. Matra sparshasu kaunteya sita ushna sukha dukkadaya agama pahino anityaha pam titikshasva bharata. He says, as you interact in the world, you will experience all kinds of experiences. Sita ushna, hot, cold, sukha dukkha, happiness and sorrow. But remember one thing, as Jesus has said, this shall also pass. Even these difficult moments that we are going through shall also pass. Agama pahino anityaha. Everything is temporary. The good is temporary, the bad is temporary. Pam stitikshasva bharata. He says, I want you to be very strong. And if you are very strong, not only physical fitness is very important, but to be have a lot of fitness and flexibility in the mind. And what is this? You know, whatever God gives me, I'm going to accept it cheerfully. I'm going to be strong enough to accept. Let that key word be acceptance. If you visit Jerusalem, in Jerusalem there is one of the most holiest places for all religions, three important religions, it is the holiest place. In Jerusalem, at the heart of Jerusalem is the Great Western Wall, very sacred for the Jews. From there, or from this point, you can see the Al-Aqsa Mosque, which is a very significant, the third holiest place for the Muslims. After Mecca, Medina, it is the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem. And you have the steeple, the point exactly where Jesus was crucified. All three are, you know, in one glance, you can see all these three places. And the message from all these religions, in Islam, the message goes, Inshallah. Just like we say, Titiksha, Inshallah. Whatever God gives me this moment is what is best for me. Thy will be done. And if I'm able to have that cheerful acceptance of whatever I am, that is where we are rooted, and to work to reach for the skies. To reach for the skies, we need to have a tremendous sense of self-esteem. You know, one of the reasons why I never excelled anywhere in school, I never came up to the platform, was a terrible sense of a low self-esteem. And when you have that low self-esteem, you feel, you know, I don't deserve all that. But finally, you know, through circumstances, through teachers, you realize that unless, like when that great footballer said, if you don't realize your goodness, your greatness, who else is going to recognize? Each one of us have to recognize something of the extraordinary in each one of us. Let me tell you a story. It's not a story, that is something really happened. Somewhere near Bangkok, there was a temple. There was a huge clay statue of Buddha. The temple was being renovated. And as the renovation happened, the statue had to be moved. In the process, something goes wrong. The statue falls down and breaks. And to their amazement, they find it is not an ordinary clay statue of Buddha, but a golden statue of Buddha. When the Buddhist monks made this golden statue, they heard the news that there was an invasion and some foreign troops were coming, and certainly they would pounce on the gold. So very hastily they covered it with clay. And it was such a closely guarded secret, when they died and their followers died, they had forgotten that in this temple they had a golden statue of Buddha. Symbolically for all of us, externally our body mind is the clay statue of Buddha. But within each one of us is the golden Buddha waiting to be surfaced. Very often when our teachers and our parents mold us, as children we feel very uncomfortable. Michelangelo was working on a block of marble and somebody said, "What are you doing?" He says, "Christ is there within this block. I only have to chip off that which is unnecessary." Friends, there is divinity in all of us. And when parents sometimes chip on us, or the teachers have given some hard strokes at this moment on the day of graduation, I know it is impossible to forget, but it is possible to forgive. And if you are able to forgive those teachers, those parents, for those harsh words which might have come out inadvertently in certain circumstances, if you can be big enough to be able to forgive. Who can be big? How do you become big? Think. If we have that sense of gratefulness. This teacher who introduced me so nicely spoke, and she said, there's a TED talk that I would like to listen you to listen. I will give you the link. Let me wait for his name to come. The title of the talk is, "Are Happy People Grateful or Are Grateful People Happy?" Think. Happy people means those who have all the best in the world. Are they likely to be grateful for what they have, or are grateful people happy? The answer is, grateful people are happy. Whenever you are grateful, you are happy. The shortcut for happiness is gratefulness. And what do we want in life? We want to be happy. There is a nursery rhyme which comes to my mind, and I want you to repeat after me, or I want you to guess what it is. The time to be happy is now. The place to be happy is here. The way to be happy is to make others happy and to create a heaven right here. And if you can make that, your life is going to be happy all through. For that, as I said, have a strong sense of self-esteem. Although I may look ordinary, I may be not as good as somebody else in so many ways, but it is okay. In each one of us, there is that golden Buddha waiting to be manifest. And life will give you an opportunity to manifest that greatness. Can you repeat after me with all the zeal? No one is superior to me. No one is inferior to me. I am what I am. In each one of us, there is something unique which nobody else in the world has. And we have to identify, I have been brought into this world for a certain purpose. And that purpose can come from Pitrarina, Lokarina. I have not told you the third Rina. What is this? Acharya Rina. But before I go to Acharya Rina, let me go back to the parents who may be watching. And I would like to give a little message to the parents, especially as you are graduating students. I will give this message in the form of a story. The story is of a little boy who loved his dog. And when his dog fell sick, he had to personally take him to a veterinarian. And veterinarians are more expensive than human doctors, you know. So he had to spend all the money he had to get a little bit of medicine. In the doctor's clinic, it was not difficult to administer the medicine to the dog. They are skilled at how to give medicines to a big dog. But the problem when he came home is how to give that bitter medicine to the dog. And because he loved his dog, he held on to it. He opened his mouth, he opened the bottle, poured that medicine as much as was required. The moment that bitter medicine touched the lip of the dog, it struggled so much, it knocked off that bottle, and all that expensive medicine was on the floor. And the boy was so upset because he wanted to heal the dog and the medicine is on the floor. And as he was washing his hands in the wash basin, and he was using all the words that his parents sometimes use when they were upset, he saw the dog was licking the medicine from the floor. Parents, children don't refuse our medication. They refuse the way we push it down their throat. Therefore, parenting is a great art. While parents want us to be the very best, you know, sometimes be sensitive to parents if they may not have the right skills, but their intention is, after all, our very best. Another message for parents, because your children are now grown to a certain age. This is from ancient India, which goes like this. Poojaye panchavarshaye, until the age of 5, bring the child up as if it is God at home, with all love, all devotion. Dhandaye dashavarshe, from the age of 6 to the age of 16, bring the child in the vicinity of a stick, because that is the only window period for discipline. And then he says something. Prapte shodasha samsare, putram mitram achale. The moment your daughter or son reaches the age of 16, he or she is no longer to be treated like a child, but has to be treated like a friend. And another good news or bad news, this is what has been told by Khalil Gibran to parents. Your children are not your children, because as parents, we give them only the physical body. They are independent people who have come into our lives for a short period of time. And as parents, it is our duty to allow them to grow and to fulfill their own dreams, which may not be my unfulfilled dreams. So as parents, just give them the space, give them the freedom to allow them. And this is always a challenge for parents, how much freedom to give, how much discipline to give. But I know today children are far more wiser than parents themselves. And sometimes you have to tell your parents, Papa, Mama, I know my life, give me my space. And I hope your parents are wise enough to give that space to allow you to grow. As you grow, you will reach out to the skies. And then sometimes something comes into your head that you have accomplished. And what pulls you down is the ego. You know what ego stands for? Edging God out. That is why, as you reach to the skies, always remain rooted. Let me tell you the story from the life of Muhammad the Prophet. The greatness of Muhammad was his ordinariness, was his simplicity. One day the angel Gabriel comes to Muhammad and says, recite. And he says, I'm not a man of letters to recite. He says, therefore you have been selected, recite. He goes home and tells his wife, either I've gone mad or I've become a poet, because beautiful poetry is revealed to him. The word Quran means to recite. And over years, he got this revelation that it means the more ordinary you are, the more simple you are. That is why St. Francis of Assisi had given this prayer, you know, make me a channel of your peace. Let me be a conduit. It shall be my endeavor to reveal thee through my actions, knowing it is thy strength that gives me power to act, life of my life. Who's Krishna's wife? I know he had many wives, but give me one name of Krishna's wife. Rukmini, Krishna's wife, had one major problem which a modern day wife has. And you know what is the most common problem a modern day wife has? You're not spending enough time with me. You're spending more time with that flute of yours. And the question she had was, what is there in that flute that I do not have? And Krishna replies, the flute is so empty. When you are empty of the sense of who you are, the Lord will speak through you. Extraordinariness happens through ordinary people. And that is the significance of being ordinary, being rooted, being ordinary. When Buddha spoke, it was amazing. They asked him, who's your witness? I mean, tell me from where you got all this. And you will see pictures of Buddha touching the earth. He said, this earth which is supporting me is my proof. I have no other witness. This is my witness. Stay rooted. Stay ordinary. Be a nobody. And being a nobody manifests everybody. I'll conclude. At this moment, when you graduate, especially with all the themes of reach out to the skies, all of us dream that one day we will be able to do extraordinary things. And I'm sure each one of you are blessed to do extraordinary things. And for that, we need to have a tremendous sense of self-esteem. I'm okay. I'm good. I can do it. And if that sense of self-esteem comes, your mind does what is called in Sanskrit called vikalpa. Vikalpa is not dreaming, but it means visualization. You know, the SGR group, his father, Vijay Reddy's father, had a very humble beginning, but he had a possibility that I'm going to accomplish. You know, the more you think, whatever you think becomes true. You think of the extraordinary becomes possible for you. And at this day, on your graduating day, let me share a story of the dream of three trees. And I will hope that one day your dreams are going to be better than the dream of those three trees. One tree says to another, you know, it is said if you have a dream, if you have some outstanding thought coming into your mind, share it with responsible people in your life. You're more likely to work on your dreams. One tree says to another, one day when I'm cut down, I would like to be a baby's cradle. The second tree said, I'm a huge tree. I'd like to be a big ship sailing in the high seas. And the third tree says, I'm right in the top of the mountain. I would like to remain here pointing towards God. When the woodcutters came to cut the first tree, they were talking of making it into a cowshed, a manger. And the tree said, my God, a manger? I don't want to be a cowshed. Please make me a baby's cradle. They said, you have no choice. They cut it down and made it into a manger. The infant Jesus, when he was born, had to be hidden in that manger. And the tree said, my God, this is better than my best dreams. When the woodcutters came to cut this tree, the second tree, they were talking of making it into a fishing boat. The tree said, please don't make me a fishing boat. I've always dreamt of being a big ship or part of a big ship sailing in the high seas. They said, you have no choice. They cut it down and made it into a fishing boat. And the story went on that a certain fisherman called Simon Peter bought that boat. Jesus sailed on that boat. And the tree said, my God, this is better than my best dreams. When the woodcutters came to cut the third tree, they were talking of making it into a cross. The tree said, a cross? A thing of shame on which people die? Please don't do that. I would like to remain here pointing towards God. They said, you have no choice. They cut it down, made it into a cross. Jesus was nailed on that cross. And a cross all over the world is a symbol that leads people to God. If trees can dream and surpass their dreams, why not all of you graduating students from Bethany? I wish you all the very best in this day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Hegarty. I think I speak for everyone when I say that your speech was incredibly motivational and thought-provoking.
We now come to one of the most poignant parts of today's ceremony, the prayer of blessing over our valedictorians. Parents, your Zoom view windows are displayed on this LED screen, so you are with your children at this God-ordained moment, even though it is virtual. But your children are not alone, as their teachers will stand in the gaps and be among the children to bless them. It is an honor to invite at the stage Dr. Anthony Robert Charles to facilitate this blessing. He is one of the leading pediatric surgeons in Bangalore and president of the Bethany Educational Board. He is also a celebrated Bethany alumni and a Bethany parent.
It is always a blessing to be here in Bethany, especially with amongst our children and the parents who are watching from at home. But most of all, my dear children, today, before I go on to the solemn part of the program, is that you are a precious and blessed child of your parents, of your teachers, and your school. And remember that preciousness as you go forth from here. Thank you, Dr. Hegarty, for setting our children onto this path. Dear parents, this is the first time, I think, as has been mentioned, we are having this valedictory without you. But I think we also have you in a very bound fashion through our Zoom sessions. And we're going to do this together. I stand here on behalf, A, of the board, two, as a parent, and three, on behalf of all of my teachers here in the school. This segment, to me, is really precious. Because as parents, you have a position to provide for your children, which you have done. And also, you are in the position today of standing in the place of God, of being God's tool to bless your children. You are an ambassador of God to your child. And today we have the divine right to administer God's blessing to our children on this occasion. Why do they need blessings? Blessings to overcome evil and blessings for them to unlock their true potential, for every day of their life, which is to come. When you speak a blessing, when you pray a silent prayer, it carries a certain power. But when you speak the blessing, there is an added power in those words. And this is what we are going to harness today as parents. I know it sounds odd when we ask you to bless your child over the internet. The internet is used for many things, but I think prayer is one of those things we're going to harness today. Because God's promises can traverse through any medium and traverses through the sincere heart of a parent, it is really powerful. God looks at the intentions of the heart, and as long as you believe today in what you're saying as a prayer for your child, it's a powerful moment for your child. So here's how we go about it. The children have teachers around them who will lift their hands towards your child. Due to social distancing norms, contrary to what we normally do, they will not lay hands on their heads, but they will do it from a distance. I request you parents at home to lift your hands too, so that your child can see you on the large LED screen I have behind me, and they know that you have your blessings over their head. And then I will read out six promises and blessings from the Bible, line by line, and I request you to please repeat after me as I say them. I will give you time to repeat after I finish. As a blessing over your child with all of your heart. Don't worry, parents, you're doing it in the comfort of your home. Nobody else is watching you, so you can do it with every intent of your heart. So here we go. So our hands raised towards our children, teachers and guests, can we have your blessings, all our staff who are here. God, we acknowledge that you have plans to prosper and not to harm us. Parents, repeat, I declare that promise over my child. God, you knew my child even before he or she was knitted together in the womb. My child is precious to you. I declare that promise over my child. God, those who listen to your commands will be made the head and not the tail, going forward and not backward. I pray this promise over my child. God, we know that if we make our refuge in you, no evil or plague will come near us, as you will order your angels to protect us. I declare that promise over my child. God, your word says that the steps of a man are established when he or she commits the steps to the Lord. I declare this blessing over my child. Parents, thank you for pronouncing these promises over your child. And if you have believed what you have said, it doesn't matter if it is virtual or in the real world, your words have power and your words will carry those blessings for your children. And since they are based on scripture, it says these promises and these blessings will not return empty. They will bear fruit. Let us pray as we close. Father, we are so humbled by the trust that you have in each of us as parents. I pray, Lord, that your presence will go with every child who is passing out here today. I pray that the words spoken will be like a banner over them, bringing protection and favor to manifest over the days ahead in their life. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And we pray all this in the precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Robert, for that. It was so meaningful. I still have goosebumps. One of the bad things that happened, one of the worst things that happened with this work from home, study from home, online classes, is everybody, especially young ones, got into the shell. and they got so comfortable there. They were just very happy to be dark and lonely, very comfortable there, buried in the lies that they believed in. They felt very safe and sound, stuck in the ground, but they felt too lost to be found. But this song says it's time to rise up. Rise up. Right? Can you hear the voice of Jesus calling? Just like Lazarus was called out of the grave, he's saying rise up. Yeah? So the staff or the music department will present the song for you. Let's go.
In the dark and all alone, smiling comfortable, are you too scared to move or walk out of this doom? Buried underneath the lies that you believe, safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just asleep, and it's time to leave. Come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus?
Rise up, rise up,
out from the grave like Lazarus.
When he called your name, the thing that filled your veins was more than blood, the kind of love that washes it away.
Now the door is open wide, the stone's been rolled aside. The old is gone, the night has come, so come on and rise up. Take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus?
Rise up, come on and
rise up. Rise up, out from the grave like Lazarus.
Calling us to walk out of the dark. He's giving us new resurrected hearts. Oh, he's calling us to walk out of the dark. He's giving us new resurrected hearts. Oh, come on.
Rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? Rise up, rise up, out from the grave like Lazarus.
Rise up,
rise up, rise up, out from the grave like Lazarus.
Thank you.
We have one more parent who wishes to send their appreciation.
Hi. And good evening. They say that school is considered the second home, and the initial years for our children are so critical towards shaping who they will become as future leaders and future adults. And I believe that Bethany has successfully been able to bring together a structured environment, yet has also remained caring, kind and compassionate for our children to feel safe enough to grow and unfold. I want to acknowledge each teacher that has been instrumental in shaping our children. Being a parent, you probably agree that even with one or two children, it can be so challenging. And teachers provide the environment for so many children to come together, to handhold them, to guide them, and to encourage them to be themselves. So I want to take a moment to pause and speak on behalf of all of the parents present here watching in, to acknowledge that Bethany is that environment. As I recall over these years of my child's education, that provides love and abundance that I always feel into when I visit Bethany, but also through my son's eyes. And I believe that this is the kind of environment that encourages children to learn play, which implies the intelligent integration of the child and the adult psyches, which are necessary to direct us to fully understand and fully acknowledge freedom and understanding. And I want to take a moment to thank Mr. Akash Ryall and Mr. Robert Khin, all the teachers, all the administration, for all the love, the kindness, and the support that you have provided each of our children through these years. And as they're passing out, I'd like to also send only the best that life has to offer to all of the students watching in. To be yourself, move forth with courage, and remember all the lessons that Bethany has taught you. And I only have deep gratitude and love for the entire Bethany experience.
Good evening. I'm Shivranjani Shankaraya from 12 Science. I stand here today to tell you a story. And at the end of it, all of us would have something to take with us. When I was about 2 years old, I suffered from appendicitis. And apparently, my condition was critical. My parents could not afford the surgery. And even the doctors gave up on me. Mrs. E.H. Ryall, or Baby Auntie, as we all fondly know, became my guardian angel. She not only paid for the surgery, but from then on took me under her loving wings. And she became the ballast of my family, the anchor that kept us steady. Do not judge me as I say this, that there are some people who are rich and make the underprivileged actually feel underprivileged. Baby Auntie, on the other hand, is a shining example of a person who is kind-hearted, generous, humble, and beautiful from inside out. Akash, sir, you are my superhero. You have always, without exception, made me feel who I am, and you've always comforted me. Robert, sir, you've always shown so much love and trust in me. Every teacher and staff here, you're completely responsible for who I am today. And I feel like a little child with all the love that you showered upon me. The surgery that I mentioned at the beginning of my story, well, Dr. Robert Charles, the president of the Bethany Education Board, and his medical team gave me the second lease of life. Thank you, sir. This is my story, dear friends. I needed financial help. I needed an education, love, acceptance, and exposure to a better life, and a vision to achieve greater goals. And Bethany gave me the best of all that. In a few years, all of us would have finished college and started earning. Let us not focus on only making as much money as possible, but let's make a promise to find ways to bring a change in somebody's life. Just like Bethany altered my destiny, there are so many kids out there who are hoping for a change. If you can make someone happy someday, you have added value to your existence. The world needs more Bethanys, and you and I need to carry that light from here to wherever we end up in the future. So now, it is my privilege and honor to call on stage a person who lit up my life, chased the darkness away. The vice president of the Bethany board, Mrs. E. H. Ryall and Anne Ryall, to lead us in the candle lighting ceremony. Auntie.
This pandemic has drained out the meaning of words like certainty, planning, and even a world like wisdom. We have no assurance when or how this will all end. And that's why we have to hold on to the words of Jesus even more. Jesus said, "You are the light of the world. A city on a hilltop that cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp and then puts it under a basket. Instead, a lamp is placed on a stand where it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your good deeds shine out for all to see, so that everyone will praise your Heavenly Father. As Bethanites, I pray that each one of you will shine your light and promote truth, joy, love, and peace. This candle symbolizes the light of God that we receive, and you must pass on the light to others you meet along the road of life. I now invite Akash, Robert, Angeline, Malika, Sangeeta, and Minnie to come up and light their candles, and in turn pass on the flame to our new valedictorians. Is that you will be quick to recognize the light of truth, even though the difficult times we are in is emphasizing a different reality. Truth is always the same, only the packaging changes. So I pray that God will give you all the courage to spread the light of truth in this distorted world. Remember, your life is God's gift to you. What you do with it is your gift to God.
Of truth and justice, joy and hope, love and peace. May it brighten our future, however challenging.
May it guard our successes, rooted in God.
May it teach us to have dignity and to honor people.
May we be beacons of light.
Like our school is a lighthouse to many.
Thank you, Mrs. Anne Ryall and Baby Auntie, for lighting up and blessing the path of the lives of the graduates. It's been an unforgettable evening, an evening of hope bubbling up from dry ground, of beacons lighting up paths that were once in the dark.
Once more, Bethany High is proud to unleash into an unsuspecting world a host of well-equipped warriors, always on the side of eternal hope, aiming for the sky while yet staying grounded in the fertile soil of reverence for God. Mrs. Sangeeta McCarran, headmistress of Bethany High Sarjapur, will now declare a prayer of commitment over the graduates.
Let us bow our heads as we look to the Lord in prayer. Lord Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time to bow our heads before you with gratitude and thanksgiving as we commit our precious students to you. Lord, thank you for your grace that has been with them through the last year, with all its uncertainties and hurdles. Thank you that you are our anchor, our ever-present help. Lord, even as our students face their board examinations, we commit them to you. Quieten them with your love, fill them with your wisdom, embolden them with your presence. May your favor surround each one of them. May your grace be sufficient for them, and may your strength be made perfect in their weaknesses. Lord, we bless them with your word that promises us that you know the plans that you have for them, plans to give them a future and a hope. As they get ready to leave the portals of our institution, we pray that even as they soar on eagle's wings, they would remain rooted in you, that they always know that they are part of the Bethany family and that they are loved and prayed for. Enable them to discern what is right, good, and just, to stay true to their dreams and to use their gifts wisely and in service to others. Empower them to walk into the future with faith, hope, honesty, and integrity. We ask all this in Jesus' most precious name. Amen.
Thank you, Sangeeta, ma'am.
We thank each one of you for being here to encourage and applaud our graduates. For being here to give our unique 2021 batch a glorious graduation ceremony. We thank you, parents who are watching at home, for your blessings. Valedictorians, please remember to collect mementos and some special surprises from your assigned teachers. This includes, by the way, dinner. There are packages that you can carry home to your parents.
Our graduates will now leave the ground in a recessional while the choir sings the song Take to the Sky by the band Owl City. Chase your dreams and remember me, sweet bravery. Because after all, those wings will take you up so high.
So bid the forest floor goodbye as you race the wind and take to the sky.
Shipwreck in a sea of faces.
circle burst of paper birds. This picture paints a thousand words. So take a breath, omit that mystery, and don't look back.
Chase your dreams and remember me, sweet brave.
HODs and our chief guest tonight. Have a lovely evening. We thank you all on behalf of our batch of 2021 for this unforgettable memory.
Thank you and good night.